My presentation on the theme with regard to cultural tourism development. Dear friends, the business of tourism or the idea of the tourism starts from breaking from the routine or breaking from the stereotype or mundane life. Most of us get fatigue both mentally and physically. We used to break the routine of our life and we used to go to some place that will give us energy and that will invigorate us, enrich us mentally and physically, and we come back home with energy, and that contributes to the productivity of the nation, to the organization. The whole idea is revolving around how tourism plays a critical role in enhancing the knowledge, enriching the experience, and strengthening our metabolism. That is more important. And how cultural tourism plays a role in strengthening the invigoration and enrichment of the human life. That I used to emphasize upon. This is related to the area of research, because this is the seminar which has been organized to give space to academia and practitioners to put forth their viewpoints and their opinions and defend them, so that many of the researchers can take the cue from the idea to be floated by many of us. Enrichment of cultural tourism through authenticity and nobility, does it need commodification? Because in one hand, we used to promote tourism because it is an economic phenomena. So it is a phenomena which connects the people to people, and it creates harmony, international understanding, national integration, and the over and above, it creates a congenial atmosphere where people of the different world or people of different regions understand each other, so that we can have a peaceful society and peaceful life, and the whole world will be in peace. So tourism promotes peace and harmony. So cultural tourism plays a very pivotal and critical role in spreading and propagating peace and harmony all over the world. Dear friends, if you separate or if you remove culture from the tourism, the existence of tourism is a question mark. There will be no existence of tourism. So therefore, culture constitutes the core element, core component of the tourism. I must say, nature comes under the culture. So culture has a broad canvas, is a broad umbrella. Whatever you wish to touch upon, whatever we wish to promote or attract or present, is a part and parcel, an integral part of the cultural tourism. So therefore, culture is the mirror of the society. It presents the age-old tradition of a society, of a nation, of a country, or of a ethnic group, or a particular society, for which tourists from one place to another wish to come and learn and understand how the dynamics a society has. So therefore, every tourist wishes to know what is authenticity and what is novelty, because no, in the end of the day, we all look for value for money. It is not that we go to a place just for a break. We wish to go visit a place for spending money, and we wish to get the value for money. So will the amount of expenditure be matching the needs and wants of a particular tourist? This is a question mark. Therefore, each and every tourist wishes to visit a destination which must be authentic and which must be giving a novelty, or the experience they must not have obtained or must not have earned before. That is one of the most important aspects for the cultural tourism. So cultural systems create genuine, authentic world that are experienced as real. Because when a destination presents the cultural beauty, the cultural attractions in such a manner that the tourist will feel the originality. That means the cultural attractions, which was the broad introduction and recognition of a particular destination, when it is presented to the tourist feel that our forefathers, when they visited the place, they experienced the same kind of experience the way we wish to do the experience today. So therefore, there must be a connect between what the tourist visited 10 years ago, 20 years ago, 30 years ago, when the tourist visited the place. This is question of sustainability of cultural tourism. So this is about the cultural tourism, you know. So in this particular diagram, the cultural tourism constitutes the four important elements. One is called experiential or conceptual aspects, because, you know, experiential tourism, when tourists visits the place, they wish to experience as a participant. When they participate in the activity, sometimes tourists come to Rajasthan, come to Agra, they themselves wish to learn the classical dance, they themselves wish to learn the classical music, they become the participant in the activities. Sometimes they wish to enjoy the activity being a spectator. So that this is a cultural tourism typology, because, you know, if you look at the slide, so there are typography or typological aspects of the cultural tourist. So a tourist, when visits a place, wishes to know the cultural tradition of the place. And who is a cultural tourist? Because, you know, primarily when a tourist starts collecting information, reading about the place, and gets enticed with the attraction of the place, and decides to visit the place, and spends quite a substantial time at the destination to learn and get educated, get enlightened with the cultural activities, cultural tradition of the place, we must say he is a cultural tourist. And the tourist who has interest in the culture must have the time to spend and stay at the particular destination. If the tourist does not stay at a destination, must not be experiencing the cultural beauty of the place. So therefore, we expect the tourist to stay longer duration at the destination, so that he or she would leave the destination with beautiful and wonderful experience. So this is, all of you must be knowing about Ganga Arati, the grand evening ritual at Varanasi, Uttar Pradesh, and it is a great tradition if you go to Harkedhun in Haridwar. And this is Ganga Arati. This is one of the reflections of the Ganga Arati, and this is the impact of the culture, you can say the live culture. So what they see from the temple, and what they see from the interaction with the community members, interaction with the priest, interaction with the others at a destination, but they can see the Ganga Arati, and this is a kind of lifetime experience for the tourist. This is the Kar festival of Puri. As all of you know, this is a festival which woos more than 15 lakh tourists in a single day. So therefore, this is a huge challenge, because majority of them are excursionists. They come from the nearby villages, nearby the city of Odisha, and they stay till the three chariots reach at the destination, and they leave Puri immediately. But majority of them, they stay in Puri just to see the activities immediately after the Kar festival. And it is a week-long festival, and they wish to see the festival throughout the week. And each day is different for experience, for obtaining the experience as far as the Kar festival is concerned. And this is a Pushkar Mela. As all of you know, that Pushkar, which is located in Rajasthan, very close to Ajmer, and you can drive about 2.5 hours or 3 hours from Jaipur. And Pushkar Mela is Pushkar is known for the Brahman temple, the only one temple in the country, and known for the camel festivals. And this is you know, this is in Cochin. This is activity based tourism. As all of you know, tourists are no longer interested for the sightseeing. And now many of the tour operators have introduced the storytelling concept, so that a tourist can spend more time at a destination listening to the stories. So this is Brihadrasa temple in Tanjore, one of the World Heritage Sites in Tamil Nadu. So this is a temple, you know, one of the tallest, I must say, the tallest temple, tallest ancient temple in the country, and attracts foreign and domestic tourists to Spain. So that this is a place where the sound and lights program is required to be introduced, so that the tourists can stay long. So changing tourism scene post-modern times, you know, these are some of the aspects. Some of the researchers may take a cue, or may start undertaking or carrying out the research. The depthlessness of the tourist experiences, how much tourists wish to have the experience, because, you know, in tourism we say experience, but in the other business they say satisfaction. These are the two differences. Second is the disinfection of the tourist experience, marginalization, and these are the two other aspects which are creating the spoiling role of the cultural aspects of the destinations. So emergence of a new breed, you know, the change in being a tourist, the newest tourist, because you know, the tourists, as I mentioned, as I told all of you, is that those who wish to become a tourist to search for cultural pursuit, they read a lot. So therefore, the newest tourist, they are highly educated and they are very conscious, experience driven, serious leisure, and truth seeking and authentic tourist. So these are the challenges before all of us when we wish to package or program any of the attractions to attract the tourists and make them stay longer. Living at the times of an inauthentic postmodern world, computer automation, imitation, virtual experiences, because many of the tourists, they wish to go to such a off the beaten track, the places which are not visited at all, and they wish to visit some of the places which are less visited. The footfall of the tourists are very less, so therefore they can have the authentic experience. So this slide, I will end up my presentation with a slide with the commoditization of a destination's culture, because you know, when tourism becomes a business and culture becomes a product, so therefore how we can make the product more attractive? So therefore you use the technique of packaging and programming. When you use the concept of packaging, so package includes multiple services, multiple facilities, so that tourists can get engaged in different activities. When we try to promote cultural a destination to attract more number of tourists, then the preservation is a question mark. So therefore, we have to find a middle path. We have to find a practical approach where the destination will not be spoiled, and the tourists will have to leave the destination with experience, and the cultural beauty of the place can be preserved forever. So this is the view I have defended through my presentation, and some of these researchers, some of the students can take up mini projects or micro projects and carry forward and carry on the research works, so that the challenges before the cultural tourism can be studied and the solutions can be immersed. And the title of the seminar is, you know, managerial implications, policy implications, so that the researchers and think tanks can think seriously how the cultural tourism attraction can be preserved forever and for posterity, for future generations and future tourists.